anyone sing well? We figured 9 News anchor Tanya O'Rourke wouldn't mind a little public humiliation to find out.
You know, Julie, I used to think I sang well. In the car, I'm a rock star. Well, now I owe apologies to my family and friends for suffering through what has been decades of me crooning, or what I now know as croaking. It seems auto-tune may be a great device for those who can actually carry a tune, but it's not going to make me a pop star. You keep pushing me aside, I can't break through. Do you hear that little warble? The digital sound in Cher's voice? That's auto-tune. Audio files hold this up as the first time people really heard auto-tune working.
Do you like auto-tune?
If I don't hear it, I love it. As soon as I hear it, I hate it.
Irwin Musper's a world-renowned music producer who just happens to have a studio in Northern Kentucky. He says the list of artists who don't use auto-tune is probably smaller now than those who do.
For pop music, this is the gadget to use, and it's a little bit overused these days, especially in pop music, and mainly with singers that look better than they sing.
Artists like Britney Spears reportedly use auto-tune to make their voices sound perfect. Auto-tune knows perfect pitch, and when it hears something slightly off, and you can see that vibrating line here, it will correct it. It can correct a little or a lot, which makes a voice sound almost electronic.
Oh my gosh.
Like that, or like this.
It'll get from one note to the next one without any bend. And that will sound artificial, like this.
I would have given you all of my heart.
Yes, that's me singing. We'll get back to it. Musper says singers like Christina Aguilera.
Every day is so wonderful.
Don't need auto-tune.
Doesn't use it.
She's a singer.
She's a singer.
She's a singer.
Okay, we put auto-tune to the test. I got a band, real rock and roll musicians.
I am Chuck Land.
I'm Alex Lusht, and I play with the Newbies here in town.
I'm Tennis Mounts.
I'm Ryan Malott. I play with 500 Miles to Memphis.
Oh dear, that's not intimidating. So they play beautifully, and I try to sing on key, a Sheryl Crow song that I sing in the car like a rock star.
I would have given you all of my heart.
Yikes. Well, auto-tune will save me, right?
And he's taken just all that I have.
Did you hear all those notes he had to correct?
But if you want, I'll try to love again.
I really was flat.
You were flat, yeah. if it does that, it means we raise it. If it's just doing a little bit, it means you were really right on in tune. There's always a little bit of stuff because that's a human factor, but we can also do this.
I would have
and suddenly you're just as good as Britney Spears.
I'm thinking that's not a compliment. So here it is, folks, the bare bones. Just my voice. Get your earplugs now.
I would have given you all of my heart.
This is with a little auto-tune, so you shouldn't hear it too much.
The first cut is the deepest. Baby, I know.
And here it is with that pixelated, over-auto-tuned sound.
But when it comes to being lucky, he's cursed.
Let's not celebrate a record deal just yet.
This thing could turn me into a singer.
It could turn you
into a pop artist.
It could turn you into a pop artist that is very, what's a nice word, passable.
I'm sorry, I totally botched that.
So there's the proof that auto-tune can fix, but not entirely repair, voices. I'll keep my singing now to the car. From now on.